Okay, first up, we have some news from the state of Tamil Nadu. There's just been so much talk and mystery that has over the late chief minister's death. And now we hear that Chinnamma's nephew, or TTV Dinakaran, has said that all the circumstances leading to the death of the late chief minister has been captured in a video. He claims that that video, in fact, was shot by his aunt, Sasikala, who's right now in prison in central jail in Bengaluru. TTV Dinakaran, however, has said that they will now produce that particular video of the late chief minister that was recorded in the hospital to probe panel that has been appointed to find out what led to the late chief minister's death. Let's listen in.
I told you, it is not CCTV, video footage. It was taken for a personal, it is a personal video taken by my aunt in request of my leader, late leader. So if at all necessary, we will produce it only in the judicial inquiry or any other inquiry. But we will ask them not to. Because she is in the medical dress, and so we don't want that to be.
Let me go straight across now to India Today's Pramod Madhav, who joins us for more. And Pramod, that is one key ask by TTV Dinakaran and Sasikala, that the video that apparently has been shot by Sasikala should not be made public to respect the privacy of the late chief minister.
Very much, Avantika. This particular video, like the one TTV has explained, it is a personal one, and they claim that Jayalalithaa, just to maintain her dignity, they don't want to release it to the public. But if their probe comes in, they will definitely give it to Justice Arumugaswamy, who is heading the probe. The interesting part here is that if this video, as they claim, is to be true, it's going to completely shake whatever DCM, OPS and all other people, including Manoj K. Pandian, PH Pandian and other leaders have stated. Because all their life they have claimed right now, from September to now, that Jayalalithaa was ill-treated by Sasikala and her family, and that is why they rebelled against her, stating that there is too much discrepancy within the death of Jayalalithaa. If this video, as it claimed by TTV, claims shows that Jayalalithaa and Sasikala having a good conversation, and if there is a kind of a passive mode in it, it is going to completely prove that whatever they have said is completely wrong, Avantika.
But one thing that one doesn't seem to understand is that after a detailed description was given by the Apollo doctors, the special team from Ames, Dr. Richard Bale, the medical report that clearly states that there were no injury marks on the late chief minister's body when she was admitted, why the questions are still being asked, why the mystery still continues around her death, which will only fuel speculation and rumors.
Well, Avantika, the medical report from Apollo, Ames and all other documents which clearly state that nothing was wrong when the chief minister was brought inside. I mean, physical injuries were only issued on March, but they started this rebel back in January itself, and that is why this medical reports have become irrelevant to OPS team. But the unfortunate thing is that after OPS became the deputy chief minister, he or his team is not talking about those kind of medical reports or anything right now. They are only going for a judicial probe. That is where even there was too much confusion as to why they're asking for a judicial probe, even after the hospital, the Apollo team and the Ames team have given a detailed explanation as to what has occurred to her. Yet it is all only seen as a political play. If this video, the one that was going to play a crucial role, seems to be a proper and a right one, that is also going to completely prove OPS team's case as a false one, Avantika.
You see, Rajashekaran also joins us right now on the broadcast. Sir, good afternoon. Thanks so much for speaking to us on lunch break. Now, TTV Dinakaran has said that he is willing to give the video, apparently shot by his aunt Sasikala, to the commission of inquiry that has been constituted by EPS, OPS. What do you make of this?
See, now today, after this announcement made by EPS and OPS, Sasikala stands vindicated, because there was so much of mudslinging and tarnishing the image and name of Sasikala and family, that they had attacked her, they had pushed her before admitting, all this stuff. But the Apollo hospitals have submitted a report, both in the court and the government. And also the Ames doctor have come forward and submitted a report about Jayalalitha's treatment and health. So as far as this video is concerned, as Sasikala had claimed that she didn't want the lion Jayalalithaa, the roaring lion, the hospitalization videos to go viral, because she wanted Jayalalitha's reputation and her image to stand high, tall, always. So that is the reason they didn't want to reveal or release the video. So today, the TTV Dinakaran has said that if the inquiry commission...
No, so do you think this video will help put all those rumors to rest? Do you think that this video is that crucial piece of evidence that will put an end to all the rumors and all the speculation that's been doing the round surrounding the late chief minister's death?
Yes, definitely, because nobody is aware what had happened inside the Apollo hospitals for the past that period of 75 days. And everybody is very curious to understand what had really happened, whether she was given treatment, okay, whether she was conscious or she was unconscious. All this would be revealed in the public space if at all the video is exposed to the public to watch it.
No, but that's something that TTV Dinakaran will be asking the probe commission not to do, not to reveal that public, not to reveal that video to the public. Narayan Tirupati from the BJP also joins us for more on this. Sir, your reactions to that statement that was made by TTV Dinakaran, him wanting to give the video as part of the ongoing investigations around the demise of the late chief minister, but his only request is that particular video should not be made public in order to respect the privacy of the late chief minister?
No. See, the life, health, and the public care about Jayalalithaa is very important than the reputation. So when people don't care for their reputation, they care for Jayalalithaa's health, they cared for Jayalalithaa's life. So these arguments of saying that they are very worried about the reputation, all those things looks very silly. So these videos should come out. If at all there is any truth or videos will reveal something, what is there in doing it openly to the public?
Why should it be revealed to the public if the probe agency headed by a retired judge is already investigating the same? I mean, don't you think it'll unnecessarily once again revive those memories, incite some sort of tension in the state?
No, there no tension will arise in the state. Only because these people suppressed all these issues, the tensions came. If they are very clearly, politely, transparently revealed about the health of Jayalalithaa, then and there itself, I think there would not have been any kind of instability even now. The main problem, the main culprit is Sasikala and company only. So who are they to say that...
So that's a charge that needs to be investigated by the probe agency that has now been constituted. But now, for now, Mr. Tirupati and Mr. C. Rajashekaran, thanks so much for joining us.